Now we have seen the color reproduction of the whole chain in our imaging system. And the question is, how good are the colors reproduced by our imaging system? On the one hand, we have the colors as perceived by the eye and the brain. On the other hand, you have the color reproduction by the lens, the camera system, and the display. And you have to compare how well those two match. That's called color fidelity. To assess color fidelity in the lab, we most of the time use first such a color checker, which has patches of different colors and different grayscales, and it's a very well-known object, a very well-calibrated object, and that gives us the first information of how well do I correct the colors, how close are they to the real perceived colors by the eye. I can illuminate that color checker under different illuminations and check for different light conditions. So the color checker in the lab helps us to check whether the colors are as close as possible to the reality. But is it what we want to achieve? The expectations of the common user are normally that the colors are more vivid, have more saturation, are brighter than how they are actually perceived in reality. That's what we observe in consumer photography, in smartphone photography, or in social media. So in general, screen colors tend to be more vivid than they actually are perceived. With ZEISS Natural Colors, we wanted to give the user the possibility to get the colors as precisely as possible, as close as possible to how they are perceived on the scene. This addresses the need of ambitious photographers to be able to, first of all, know what was exactly the color on the scene, and second of all, be able to recognize how the post-processing on the colors can be done, what is the latitude that they have on the image to enhance the colors of the image. Let's look at a direct comparison between the ZEISS Natural Color mode and the regular Vivid mode. You see here a beach and the sea and the red house on top of the beach. And you can clearly see that the Vivid mode has more saturated, more bright colors than ZEISS Natural Color mode. However, the ZEISS Natural Color mode has colors that are much closer to what has really been perceived. So how do we get to that ZEISS Natural Color mode? So first we go into the lab and we measure defined targets like that color checker or scene boxes that we have put together, and we try to be as quantitative as possible. We do quantitative measurement, which will include the properties of the optics with color transmission, color shading, the properties of the sensor, the color response, infrared, low light response, and also the properties of the algorithms such as white balance and color correction. Let me just say that we can do all that work already on the design phase because we have all the properties that we know from the different components, and then verify them in the lab and measure them quantitatively in the lab. For instance, we can also go in the lab into low light situations with real objects like such as skin tones or flowers, and check that the colors are also well reproduced in low light situations. After we finish the tuning in the lab, we still have to go outside to perform some fine tuning because there are some situations that we cannot reproduce in the lab. As an example, here you see a wheat field with green grass in front of it and a blue sky. That's the kind of situations we are looking for outside in order to make some fine tuning of the colors. And in order to match the natural colors as best as possible, we also have to go outside and be on the scene to really see what the color, the actual color of the scene was, in order to make a fine adjustment to our algorithms. Another challenge that comes with current smartphones is that instead of having only one lens and one sensor like classical cameras, smartphones have now 1, 2, 3, 4 different camera modules with different lenses, different sensors, and different field of views. And we have to make sure that all the colors reproduced by those different cameras match together. So the field of view differences between, for instance, the ultra-wide camera and the tele camera will affect the white balance and the exposure of the scene. The different spectral responses of the different sensors will affect also the color reproduction and so on. So ZEISS Natural Colors gives the user the opportunity to get colors as accurate as possible and opens therefore a space for post-processing for color manipulation that has never been there before. So, in conclusion, we have seen that color perception is not about a physical process, but also about how the brain interprets and processes the colors that it sees. On the other hand, we have to teach our camera systems to reproduce the colors in the same way as the brain does. And as technology evolves, we are more and more able to do so. In future, color science will continue to play an important role for even better mobile imaging. As color tastes will evolve, technology improvement will help us to reproduce colors even better. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed today's ZEISS Expert Talk.